Sports Gaming Universe.
Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Sam Slinger Connected Career Series here in Madden 25 on the PS4. Sam Slinger and the Minnesota Vikings won the Super Bowl in his rookie year, and now they've won the home opener in their brand new stadium as well. And now they get a second home game, this time taking on the Tampa Bay Bucks, who are now 0-1. Let's go out to the stadium and get ready for Vikings football.
We're here for this early season divisional showdown between the Buccaneers and the Vikings. Hello friends, Jim Nantz along with Bill Sims getting set for kickoff and a big primetime game headed your way. The lights are on, the excitement's building, Bill.
Yeah, it really is. I tell you what it does to players, Jim. They sit around all day long and what are the tensions build up, the excitement gets there, they come out in the field, they know it's a different game because everybody's going to be home watching them, and believe me when I tell you, players like that.
And now with more on today's game, let's go down to Danielle Bellini.
Thanks, guys. The lights are on bright down here, and these teams are ready to go. On the sidelines, players are jumping around. They are getting fired up, guys. They want to impress all the fans watching at home tonight, and of course, they want to get a win as well. Back to you.
Thanks, Danielle, and now we'll go to the field.
Wait, hold up a second. Before we go any further here, did you hear Jim Nantz call this a divisional showdown? Yeah, I don't think the Bucks and the Vikings have been in the same division for quite a while here now. That's a little bit of a gaffe. There you go. But Adrian Peterson starts the game with a 7-yard run. We got a 3rd and 3 here as we see Slinger's stats through one game. And we're going to hand off to Adrian, and that probably was not the best play call. They are there to stack that up. McCoy gets the tackle, and we'll have to punt. So in this version of an NFL universe, Josh Freeman is still a Tampa Bay Buck and still starting. So there you go. He was not traded to the Vikings in this little universe of ours, and he's still got a starting job, so good for him. But he doesn't get anything done on the first drive for the Bucks. We get the ball back and hand off to Adrian Peterson again. Let's try to set up a screen to Peterson this time. Nope, they're all over that. Going to be no gain and set up another 3rd and medium here for us, 3rd and 5. Let's see what we can do out of the shotgun. Slinger quickly finds Greg Jennings, who was wide open right there. And they get the first down on the 8-yard connection. Let's see a replay as the veteran Greg Jennings gets set here for his quarterback. Sits down after that 5-yard quick route there and gets him a first down. Now we got a flag on the field as AP just gets depleted. He does get a first down, but let's see what the call is. The refs get together. It looks like it might have been a Tampa Bay Buccaneer player in the neutral zone, and that's exactly what they're going to call. So we're going to go ahead and decline that and let AP's run stand. Hey, he got hit pretty hard. We don't want it to be for nothing there. So Slinger is going to throw to Kyle Rudolph there, and they connect for 20 yards and a Vikings first down. Nice job by Slinger to hang in there and find his open tight end. You see Jennings was the inside route that was covered up, so it was the correct read going down the field to Rudolph, and they've got a first down. So they're at the 33. Slinger throwing quickly to Ellison, who's not going to get much, maybe just minimal yardage there. 3rd and 6. Slinger wants to throw again. It's to Jennings. Turns around and gets the first down. Again, just a quick route for Jennings. Slightly different play, but it's the same result, as he's got a man on him there, but he catches that and kind of spins around quickly and gets enough for first down yardage. So Slinger's completed 5 passes in a row, but now he's going to hand off to Adrian Peterson, who gets about 6. Okay, so we are in the red zone here at the 19-yard line. Ellison in motion to the left, and we're going to a little bootleg play action here. Slinger to the goal line, but it's dropped. Oh, there was some traffic there, but if Scheffler can hang on, the Vikings are definitely in business. Instead, they got 3rd and 4, and they'll go out of the shotgun. Rudolph set to the right there in the backfield. Also, Adrian Peterson, who makes the catch out of the backfield, but they're 1 yard short. Decide to go for it on 4th and 1. At least we're lining up to do so. Slinger is going to keep it himself, and they'll give him the first down yardage. It was close, but the quarterback keeper gets him a first down. So on first and 10, Ellison in motion, and we got play action. Slinger looking to throw to the end zone, and this time it's Scheffler making the catch for the touchdown. Nice job right there, and hey, don't you dare. That's illegal in the NFL now. You're going to get flagged. Nope, no celebrations, no slam dunks. We can't slam dunk over the goalpost anymore in the no fun league, but Scheffler just did it anyway. So, yeah, that'll be interesting. I guess that'll have to come out of Madden next year as a celebration because it will be a penalty. Way to go, NFL. Way to take all the fun out of the game. All right, so I'm done with that commentary. But, hey, look at the Vikings get another score. What happened? Well, Trindon Holiday strikes again, this time on a 64-yard punt return to make it 14-0. Nice job, whoever signed Trindon Holiday. He's been a beast in the return game through two games here. So, speaking of beasts, we got Adrian Peterson carrying the rock for us once again today. The reigning NFL MVP gets taken down from behind right there, just a yard short from the first down. Let's bring in the fullback and give it to him, Felton. Doesn't get his number called very often for a carry, but he does there, and he gets a first down. So let's see what we go with on the first down call. It's going to be to Kyle Rudolph, and that'll be a quick hitter for 6 yards. Setting up second and four. We're under 4 minutes to play until the half now, and there is a counter play for Adrian Peterson that will get another first down. And here we want to throw. Slinger, again, just a quick toss. That is going to be Cordero Patterson. Been quiet to this point, but he does make a catch there and gets very close to first down yardage, coming across the formation, making the catch, and trying to get as much as he can here. Stretches out, be just short. So on second and inches, again, the fullback's in the game, but this time he's blocking for Adrian, who gets a first down. Nice job right here as we near the two-minute warning. Are we going to get a playoff before the two-minute warning? Yep, it looks like we will, and it's going to be play action. Slinger loading up. Oh, it's wide open. Greg Jennings down to the 6-yard line. It's first and goal. They fooled them on the play action there, and that's a beautiful strike from Slinger to Jennings. Now we're definitely in business with first and goal, and a nice block springs Adrian Peterson into the end zone. Touchdown, and just like that, it is 21-0 as we have things going on all cylinders for our offense, passing game, running game. It's all clicking right now, and it has resulted into a nice lead in front of the home crowd here in our brand new digs, our brand new stadium, and they are loving the experience here in Minneapolis as their Vikings are taking it to the Bucks right now. So the Bucks do get a field goal before half, so as the third quarter starts, it's 21-3. Adrian Peterson has absolutely no intention of resting in this second half. He is running hard once again, and when he's pushed out, it is a large gain for the Vikings offense. This is giving the Bucks just absolute fits on defense trying to stop this guy. But then again, what defense doesn't have trouble lining up against Adrian Peterson and effectively shutting him down? It just doesn't happen very often. Slinger has some pressure coming at him. He gets this ball quickly to Cordero Patterson, who gets leveled. Both men picking themselves up off the turf, but they did get 8 yards, so it was a successful play. Adrian Peterson gonna get nothing there, tackled by Foster, so that's gonna set up 3rd and 2. You see, we're 3 of 6 on third down conversions. Let's make it 4 of 7. Peterson has some room to run, and look at that stiff arm to finish off the play. That throws him over 100 yards on the day. He is hyped up, getting this crowd behind him. Not really that they needed it. All the play on the field has this crowd as hyped as they need to be, as the Vikings are just taking it to the Bucks right now. So, as I said, Adrian over 100 yards now as we are flying through the third quarter. Gonna hand off on a bit of a counter play there. Not a whole lot, about 3 yards. So that'll set up 2nd and 7. Another carry? No, they're gonna go play action. Slinger just kind of floats that one into Ellison. Nice football right there. Just a nice soft pass out of harm's way, and they connect for a nice play there. Slinger trying to get away and use his feet here, and he's going to get hit after getting about a gain of 3. So 2nd and 7, and nobody in the backfield except Slinger taking the snap. It's to Jennings. He gets a first down, but hold on. He dropped the football, and I believe that's Burton there to cover it up and avoid a turnover, as that ball was live. It was on the turf, and Burton very alertly covers it to keep possession for the Vikings. So it's 2nd and goal at the 1, And Slinger wants quiet from the crowd. And then he's going to take the snap and call his own number. And it's not a very exciting play there, but he does cross the goal line and get himself a touchdown. So the Vikings score again. I wish this animation was just a little more exciting. You know, instead of a quarterback just taking it and barely crossing the line and just standing there. I mean, could he at least stumble forward and tumble down to the turf? I don't know. Just something there. Can we please just finish that animation? It just feels so empty scoring that way. But anyway, we'll take the points. So it's 28-3. The Bucks do get a touchdown here, so they cut it to 28-10. And we've got most of the fourth quarter here to run the football and try to kill some time. So Adrian Peterson gets 7 right there. Second and 3, he'll get his number called again, managing to get his way through the traffic there and get a first down. Peterson once again in the backfield, but we want to throw. Slinger doesn't see anything he likes. He'll throw the football away rather smartly there. So second and 10 now, and we're going to set up a screen. And this one is a little more effective. Adrian Peterson's got the first down and more. Nice job right there on the play call, and it gets them what they want. So Adrian Peterson running once again, spinning around, falling down. He's got about 130 yards now. Felton gets another carry, and yes, give him a first down. So we're under 5 minutes to go now. Another first down run for Adrian Peterson, and he's going to get 10 or more yards there. Mark him at, I think, 11 on that gain, as we are continuing to move the football down the field and chew up this fourth quarter clock, as you see a couple replays of Adrian Peterson. You know, he only knows one way to run the football, and that's hard. And he's doing it right there. So let's see if we can continue to get forward progress here on our first down plays. Oh, we're going to go play action. It's a little surprising here, but it did not surprise the Tampa Bay defense in the end. Maben gets the sack. That was not what Les Frazier had in mind on that play, and he kind of voices his displeasure there. So they go short to Burton there, just trying to be conservative. They do pick up about 6 yards. It'll set up 3rd and 10, and I wouldn't expect anything too crazy here. Trying to see if somebody happens to be wide open, and when they're not, he throws this out of bounds. Setting up a Blair Walsh field goal attempt, and he will go ahead and hit that. Splits the uprights, and it's now 31-10. The Bucks do nothing with the football. We're under 2 minutes, and they've got 3 timeouts, but I think they realize they've been defeated on the day. They're not calling any of them here. So it's just a matter of running the clock out. Hand off to Felton. Kind of gets his clock cleaned there. But looks like one more snap unless they finally choose to call a timeout. They say, nah, we're good. And Felton and AP share a moment there. I don't know what that was. Little hug on the field there. Celebration maybe? I don't know. Rest time? Nap time? I don't know what that was. But the Vikings win 31-10. Josh Freeman, doesn't matter where you are, you're not winning ball games. But hey, at least you got a starting job in this little world we are in here. So congrats on that. Adrian Peterson, congratulations on a player of the game performance, 154 yards. Sam Slinger turns in your play of the game with this pass to Scheffler. So the pickups in free agency here, Scheffler and Trindon Holiday, showing that they can produce for this team. And big factors in the win today. So 31-10 is the victory. We improved to 2-0. Let's see what the rest of the NFC North does. They all lost in week one. If you did that again right now, that'd be very much appreciated. Nah, the Packers and Lions win. The Bears fall to 0-2. But we play the 2-0 Broncos next. That could have been the Super Bowl matchup last year, but they got knocked off by the Chiefs. So we'll be taking on Peyton Manning and the Broncos. Another home game, 3 in a row. We'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Like the SGU Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter. Go ahead and subscribe to SGU here on YouTube so you don't miss daily videos. And last but not least, follow us on Twitch for live streaming goodness.